In the first two seasons of Survivor, both winners weren't widely loved by the community, but things changed in season three, Africa. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffed, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be looking back at one of the most well-liked winners in Survivor history, winner of Survivor Africa, Ethan Zohn. We were first introduced to Ethan Zohn, a 27-year-old professional soccer player as a member of the Buron tribe, alongside Lex Vandenberg, a marketing manager from Santa Cruz, California, Kim Johnson, a retired teacher, and a 45-year-old goat farmer, Tom Buchanan. Ethan is immediately established as Mr. Nice Guy, well revered by his tribe. He comes off as warm and approachable. Early on, the tribe are eating cherries and Ethan observes that Clarence takes two. Instead of jumping up and down to stir the pot, Ethan keeps this to himself to ensure that the tribe morale remains strong and there's no drama in the camp.
I was eyeing people just because I want my equal share of cherries. I mean, it's so silly we're talking about cherries here because we're starving. And I definitely saw Clarence take two cherries at one time and pass it around him. I mean, it's so tempting in there to take two.
Although he is a professional athlete, he falls over and over at the immunity challenge, but despite this, the target when they return to camp is not placed on him. Diane is on Struggle Street, having collapsed following Buran's loss, and when the tribe go out to fetch water, Clarence stays back with her. What happens next is pandemonium. Clarence opens a can of beans, or perhaps a can of worms, helping to give Diane sustenance and in the meantime also taking some for himself. Having already seen Clarence be dishonest about the cherries, Ethan doesn't respect this deceit. But despite this, the tribe voted out Diane in a unanimous vote. Ethan formed an alliance with Lex and Big Tom to ensure their safety throughout the game. He was determined to go to the end with the strongest, but at the same time didn't fully trust Lex as he feared that he was prepared to play a ruthless game. Buron stuck strong as a unit once again by voting out Jesse and managed to win the next two immunity challenges. During this time, Ethan began to empathise with Kim Johnson, who was on the bottom of the tribe. For the first time in Survivor history, the game was turned on its head. On day 13, Buron and Samburu took part in the first tribe swap. Ethan remained on Buron with Clarence and Kim. Joining them was Silas, Frank and T-Bird. Although Ethan lost his closest allies in Lex and Big Tom, the swap turned out in his favour as Frank and T-Bird were determined to eliminate Silas, so the new Buron decided to throw the immunity challenge. The tribe was successful, and despite Silas attempting to convince Ethan to vote out Frank, Silas was sent home. At the next challenge, Ethan and T-Bird attempted to signal to Samburu that Lindsay had four previous votes against her. Their attempt was successful, and Buron held a 6-4 advantage going into the merge. Ethan cannibalised one of the members of the original Buron by eliminating Clarence and would go on to win a reward, venturing into a nearby town with Lex to barter goats and play hacky sack with local children.
I traded right off my back one of my Reebok long sleeve t-shirts. They gave me a bracelet, I gave him my shirt right off my back. I gave him my hat off my head. For even just 2 hours, I was a little bit part of their life and see how things work.
After Ethan won individual immunity, Lex was determined to vote out Kelly and the former Buron sided with him alongside Brandon. Ethan began to question whether Lex's word to Brandon was worth more than his alliance with Tom and Ethan. He managed to rally Frank, Kim Powers and T-Bird to join him in voting out Brandon, yet Lex refused to write down Brandon's name, making Ethan question their bond even further. T-Bird began to scramble to vote out Ethan in order to save herself, recognising he was a nice guy and would wipe the jury if he got to the end. Kim Johnson informed Ethan of this plan and together they plotted to eliminate the remaining Samburu members. Ethan refuted a plan from Kim to vote out Lex, stating that he wanted to play with the best. He tells Lex that Tom had considered flipping on him, resulting in Big Tom's elimination. At the final three, Kim Johnson won immunity and took Ethan to the end, remaining loyal to her closest alliance. Ethan went throughout the entire season without receiving a single vote against him, and at final tribal council, he told the jury to vote from their heart and emphasised his kindness and close relationships with the jury, winning the votes of Lex, Frank, Kelly, Big Tom and T-Bird to claim the title of sole survivor in a 5-2 vote.
The winner of Survivor Africa.
Ethan was so well liked he was invited back for All Stars and spread positivity to the community by establishing Grassroots Soccer, a non-profit organisation aimed at raising awareness to fight HIV/AIDS. After being diagnosed with a rare type of cancer called CD20 positive Hodgkin's lymphoma in 2009, Ethan returned for one last appearance in season 40, Winners at War. What did you think of Ethan Zohn's journey to the title of Soul Survivor? Let us know in the comments section down below. If you enjoy what you've seen, I'd really appreciate it if you give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. New videos just like this one every Tuesday and Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Wednesday and Friday Australian Time. Stay tuned next week as we delve into the story of Vesepia Tauri, winner of Survivor Marquesas. Kind, compassionate, and loyal to the bitter end. It is possible to win the brutal game of Survivor without burning bridges. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
It's hard to describe in words, you know, everything that was going on in my head and in my, you know, body. But it was an experience that I'll, you know, I'll never be able to forget.
You know, that was business.
Thank you.
That was business. That was insane.
As a life experience, it was a day I will never, ever forget, like, for the rest of my life.